Anyone who has seen my channel logo knows of the group called Westlife. But did you know there was a group called V? Well, if you didn't, you're not alone, because they were only around for about 2 years. I got their CD here, and it's a special edition. Even though I think all of them say that, there is actually something special about this CD that I want to show to you. If you look in the liner notes, it says, there are two hidden tracks on this album. To find out where, it says to go to this website, which no longer exists. So I'll show you how to find these hidden tracks. The first one is pretty obvious. You see the track listing here shows 13 tracks. But when you pop in the CD and let it spin up, it shows there are 18 tracks. Now the 18th track is one of the two hidden tracks. The other one isn't in 14 through 17. Those are just a couple seconds of silence each. So there's a special trick you need to do to find the hidden first track, and it will not work in a CD-ROM drive on a computer. So if you hit play, it starts playing track one. What you have to do is use your reverse search button, and if you hold it down, you see it starts counting in negative numbers because it's going before the track one into the pre-gap area. So you have to keep holding this until about 4 minutes and 40 something seconds in reverse, and that's the actual beginning of the hidden track, which I'll play for you now.
I sit and wait, I'm waiting just for you.
Okay, I won't play the whole thing because even though it's a hidden track, they might still have the copyright content ID on it. Even though it's probably impossible to download this since it's not an official track on the album. So that's how you find a hidden pre-gap track on a CD. You start it playing on track one. And once it gets going, you hit your reverse search button and keep holding it until you get to the beginning of the pre-gap track. And then you let go and you just let it play. I discovered it is possible to rip that hidden pre-gap track using Exact Audio Copy. So I have the CD loaded in the drive, and the funny thing is, if you just type the letter V as the artist name, it thinks you're marking it as a various artist's CD, so you have to type V space and then it does accept it. But the thing you do is you rip the track one, or you can even do all of them if you want, but just need to do at least the track one and let that go through. Okay, finished extracting track one. So what we do is we click on create log, and I'll just save it in my documents. And you open up that log file in Notepad or any text editor. And you'll notice it says track one, start sector, usually should be zero, but in this case it says 22,965. That means the hidden pre-gap track is hidden in sectors 0 through 22964. And you go back into Exact Audio Copy and click on Action, Copy Range, Uncompressed. And Start Position is Block 0. And you type that number in the end position, the one less than the number that the track 1 starts at. So in this case it's 22964. And you hit OK. And I'll just save it as Range, and now it's extracting that hidden track. Ordinarily you might not even know that the CD has a hidden pre-gap track, but Exact Audio Copy is nice enough to mark it in red on the first track, indicating that there is something before it that you have to use this trick to extract. It will say sync error, but if you open up the track that it extracted, it will be complete. And there is that hidden pre-gap track. They were actually nice enough not to smash the levels on it, unlike the rest of the CD.
Ooh, you got me spinning. This one's just for you.
This one's just for you.
Hello? I'm recording a hidden track for the album.
Mark, man, not where's that living?
That's not my son.
What's up, yo? Damn.
Sorry. I'll call you back later, right?